Following the devastating incident at the Katonga Bridge, Masaka Road was temporarily blocked by traffic police and an alternative route which goes through Mpiji Kanoni Sembabule Road to connect to parts of Masaka and Western Uganda was created by UNRA and traffic police. Meanwhile, road users and residents in the areas of Kamengo, Buama, Kayabwe and Nkozi were left stranded as those who crossed the bridge to either do business in Kayabwe Town Council couldn't cross from Nabiyewanga in Nkozi Rural to Kayabwe Town Council. These, with the help of fishermen at Golo Landing Sites, created an alternative route which goes through Namirembe Landing Site to Kiwami Landing Site. At the moment, each individual is charged 10,000 shillings to cross for the 30 minutes journey using a boat. Cargo is charged differently depending on the size and weight. Francis Buye, the chairperson in Nkozi Rural Sub-County, is concerned that this might inconvenience school-going children when second term commences.
I have over 900 school-going children in my area, those who attend their education from Kayabu. So those people, I don't know whether they will be able to access education from those schools across Katonga. So let the government hurry up, quicken all the means possible such that the Katonga Bridge can at least bring the temporary bridge for those people who can be affected.
Buye says the landing site hosts over 1,000 people daily who either work or use the area to connect to Kayabwe, but it has no toilets. He has called on government to provide a temporary mobile toilet to save the situation.
I call upon the government at least to send some people, doctors or nurses, to come and examine the way how the situation is being handled here, such that they send those people, they send the different drugs to cater for those people who cannot manage to cross this water to go to Nkozi to access the drugs.
Mpiji District Commercial Officer Ronald Kazibwe visited the community to assess the impact of the situation. He has vowed to engage the government through UNRA and the Minister of Works to improve on the alternative route created by residents.
Today we have identified the number of challenges that the traders go through to transport their products. One of it is the narrow path, and it needs to be widened. This narrow path causes the delays in transportation of products, and also it increases the consumption of fuel for the boats. So we are here to see how we can widen it.
Report compiled by Simon Sechide for the news.